Alright, so first off, we're gonna create our Next.js app and we're gonna go with the default options. Then we're gonna run code followed by the directory name to open it up with VS Code. Then update the app/page.tsx to take us to the sign up page. Then we're gonna be using Shadcn, so go over to doc, then dark mode, Next.js, and copy the command and paste it over here. Then we're gonna copy this code snippet. Then inside the components folder, we're gonna create a theme provider component. Then go over to layout and make sure you import the theme provider from the correct path. Then we're gonna go over here and suppress hydration warning. Then we're gonna add our sign in and sign up pages. Then pick whatever you like and copy the command, paste it over here. And we need a sign up page as well. I'm just gonna go with this one. Then we're gonna hit enter. I'm gonna go with the neutral color. As you can see, it has created our auth pages. Alright, so let's see how it works. We're gonna go to localhost 3000. It looks alright to me. Alright, the next part is quite crucial. Make sure this button takes us to the sign up page. Then this page should take us to the login page. Now we're going to look for all the input tags and add name attributes to all of these. And don't forget to do it with the login form as well. We'll be using the name attributes with the corresponding values to grab the form data. So working alright. Now we're gonna install the BETTER-AUTH library. Get started. The installation. Then we're gonna copy this command and paste it over here. Then go back and create your auth secret. Create a .env file. Paste your environment variable here. Then paste your base URL here. Then we're gonna create our BETTER-AUTH instance. Now we could use Postgres or SQLite, but we'll be using Prisma for this tutorial. So copy it, create a file called auth.ts inside lib directory, then paste the code snippet. We'll be using Postgres. Set the provider to Postgres. Now, before we run the next command, we're gonna have to install Prisma ORM first. Type Prisma BETTER-AUTH. We're gonna install Prisma as a diff dependency. Then we're gonna install Prisma client and extension accelerate. Then we're gonna initialize Prisma by running npm prisma init. Make sure to match this output path. Now make sure it's pointing to the correct path. Then we're gonna create our Prisma client. Copy the code snippet. We're gonna create a file called prisma.ts inside the lib directory. Make sure this is pointing to the correct output path. Then we're gonna run npm prisma generate to create the Prisma client. It's giving us an error. Now let's try again. Alright, it works. Alright, let's fix the errors. Then over to our auth config. We're gonna remove this. And I'm gonna add the Prisma client directly from the file. Now let's try creating our database tables. Hit Y to overwrite. Take a look at our Prisma schema. Now as you can see, it has added all these tables. Now I'm gonna remove all these useless comments. Then we're gonna create our database and grab the connection string. Log in with your account. Create a new project. Pick your closest server. Then finally hit the connect button and grab the connection string. Gonna paste it over here. Then finally, we're gonna run npm prisma migrate def dash dash name init. Check our database tables. It should add all the tables. Now we're gonna install Resend. Go to resend.com, grab your API key, create a new environment variable, and paste your Resend API key. Import Resend from Resend, create our Resend client, and pass the API key. Then we're gonna set email and password to true, set require email verification to true. Then you're gonna say user URL, await recent emails API send. Since we're on dev server, we're gonna say onboarding at recent.dev, grab the user email, and this is gonna be standard HTML. Then finally, create a new file, server/auth-actions.ts. We'll be putting all our server actions here. Create your signup action. We're gonna grab the name, email, and password from the form data. Then we're gonna import our auth instance, await auth.api.signup. And don't forget to import and await the headers from next headers. We're gonna copy and paste it. This will be our login server action. api.signin email. We're gonna copy it and create one for sign out. And finally, we're going to have to import the server actions. It's gonna import the login server action. Go over to your sign up form and import the sign up server action. All right. I forgot to show you how to add the mount handler on your API routes. Go back to the BETTER-AUTH docs. There's a section called mount handler. Copy this path. This will be inside our app directory. Paste in the name. Then go back to the docs. Copy this code snippet and paste it over here and save. And we could redirect the user using the redirect method from next navigation. Make sure you are importing this from next navigation. Now we're going to delete the user from the database. Now if we create our account, it should send us an email. And remember, for the diff build, this will only work with the email you have associated with your API key. Let's now check again. It says email is verified.